This video is a practical tutorial. We will apply all that we have learned so far about creating robot behaviors with FlexBee to complete the example picking behavior for our factory simulation. Okay, this is the state machine of the pick behavior that we started to create in the previous video. We had already added states to detect the part, compute how to pick it, move the robot to the appropriate joint configuration for that, activate the gripper, and move the robot back to its home configuration. Remember also that in the dashboard view, here we go, we have created some constant and user data variables for our specific application. Here we are. We have the behavior constant pick group that contains the robot one, move it group that we are using for picking, and the constant home one with the joint values of the home configuration for robot one. And the user data variables, part pose for the detect part state, this is the post part variable, and the joint configuration computed by the compute pick state, that is the pick configuration variable. Okay, now let's complete the configuration of all the states in our state machine. So we go back to the state machine. Okay, first, the detect part state. This state has one parameter, the reference frame in which we want to output the pose of the part. Since we will compute the pick with robot one, it seems reasonable to obtain the pose in the reference frame of that robot group. That is robot one underscore base, as we saw using MoveIt in week 4. So we write it. Do not forget the quotation marks to pass a liter of value. Now, this state has one output key, the pose of the part. So we click and the auto-completion shows us the available user data. We choose the variable we defined for this, part pose. Let's click on apply to save the changes. Always remember to do this when editing a state or you will lose what you have just configured. And we close the state. The next state is compute pick configuration. We have already configured most of it in the previous video about FlexBee states. We have set the parameter group, the input key pose, and the output key joint values to the respective user data variables. However, we haven't done anything about the output key joint names. We kept the default value FlexBee gives to state keys, but there is no actual user data called joint names. With the mouse over help, we can see that the state expects an array in this output key mapping. So let's create such a user data variable. We go back to the dashboard view. Here we are. Let's close the detect state too to see what we are doing and create the user data joint names. And we can put an empty array as default value for the variable. Okay, now back to the state machine editor. Open the state compute pick. Go to the output key. And here we can now select the user data joint names. We apply again and we close this state. The next state is move robot one to pick. First, its parameter group. This is the group for which the state will compute the grasping configuration. We select the pick group constant that, if you remember, has the value robot one. Okay, the next parameter is the action topic. In our factory simulation, this is the topic move group. You can check this by running Rust topic list when running the factory simulation and looking for the move group action topics. Okay, now the input keys. For both the joint values and the joint names, we have created user data with the same names, so we assign those. Okay, we apply the changes and close. As you can see, configuring the states of a behavior takes some clicking and selecting, many times using the same variables. But think how all the coding and passing values between functions and assigning them to different variables that this is saving us. This is more that would be more prone to coding errors. FlexBee is very handy in many senses, such as this one. Okay, only two more states to go. Activate gripper is a quite simple state. We see that it only has two parameters. Enable defines whether this instance of the state activates or deactivates this action in the gripper. Since we want to activate it, we set it to true. Now, service name. Let's see what this... Okay, it contains the topic name for the service corresponding to the gripper in robot one. Okay, if you run raw service list when running the factory simulation, you will find that this is /gripper1/control. So we set this value. Okay, we apply and close this state. Finally, we configure the last state, move robot one to home configuration. This is a moved state, same as the previous move robot one to pick. Since we are moving the same robot using the same move group, we put the same values for the parameters. So move group is pick group, and action topic is again move group. Don't be confused about the state parameter. Don't confuse the state parameter with the action topic for the move group node in our application. Sometimes different elements just happen to have the same name. Okay. Now the input key mappings. We want to move the robot to the home position. So for the joint values, it could make sense to use the constant home1 that we have defined in the behavior. However, state keys can only have a user data variable for their value, not a constant, since they are meant to support values that may change during the behavior. So we cannot select our constant. But we can easily work around this by creating that user data that takes the constant as its default value. So we apply the current changes and go to the dashboard. Now, create the home1 user data, giving it as default value the home1 constant that we already have. Again, same name for different elements, but it is okay since we refer to the same thing, the home joint configuration for robot1. Now, back to the home to move to home state. Now we can select home1 as a user data value, a variable for the input key, joint values. Okay, finally, we are almost done, the joint names. Okay, here we use the same user data with the same name in which we store the output produced by compute peak configuration. That's the joint names we created before. So we apply the changes and save our behavior. Yeah, that's it, no errors. So we have completed the configuration of our FlexBee behavior. All right, we have our picking behavior ready. Now we can execute it and see some robot action in the factory. Let's see how we execute our FlexBee behavior in the next video.